Welding is a serious business, and the consequences of getting it wrong can be immeasurable. But how much do we know about the health and safety risks associated with welding? It wasn't so many years ago that the best advice a welder would receive for the protection of their health was to wear a decent face shield and to drink milk to protect themselves from the harmful effects of welding fumes. Yes, milk. Really? Thankfully, the International Agency for Research on Cancer, as part of the World Health Organization, has concluded further significant research into the effects of welding on the human body, including substances such as beryllium, cadmium, chromium, nickel, aluminium, and mild steel welding. And its conclusion is that welding can cause cancer. Subsequently, welding is now classified as a Group 1 carcinogen. Fortunately, welding and fabrication personnel can enjoy a healthy and rewarding career, providing appropriate protective equipment is used. Work-related respiratory disease is preventable. So what is appropriate protective equipment? Well, appropriate protection can combine a number of solutions, including exhaust ventilation at source, half masks and PAPR systems, that's powered air purification respirators. As far as welders are concerned though, their immediate proximity to the welding arc means that exhaust ventilation only is simply not enough, and personal respiratory solution should be the best option. Disposable and reusable half masks work on the negative pressure principle. They're very much dependent on face fit, and they can be quite fatiguing to use because you're breathing through the filter substrate itself. But they have a relatively low entry cost point, and because they're disposable, they're okay for occasional use. But if you're using them every day, it can be a little bit smelly. You throw them away every day, and probably you're better off looking at maybe a reusable negative pressure mask. These can also fit quite well under welding screens, and silicone rubber device, very much dependent on face fit, and you're breathing through these reusable filter cartridges at the side. But probably the most effective device to use and the most cost-effective unit to use is a positive pressure respirator. And positive pressure respirators work on the principle of a battery-powered filtering device. You're taking the contaminated air through the filtering unit and passing that clean filtered air into the head top. And the head top has then got a positive pressure inside the breathing respiratory device itself, which is keeping out the contamination. And also these units aren't affected by facial hair, which half masks most certainly are, because the contaminant gets under the beard, etc. So positive pressure respirators are excellent in terms of protection level. They're very much cost effective compared to disposable devices, and they're superb for users with facial hair as well. So, I hope you found this video interesting and helpful, but if you'd like to know more about Kempe respiratory devices, then check out our website, and if you'd like further independent information, please visit your local HSE websites. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.